Can you get started in real estate investing from anywhere in the world with 10 grand? Yeah, as a matter of fact, you can. What's that gonna look like though, right? That's what you gotta ask yourself. This is your show. This is the show where I work for you directly, taking your needs. I'm going through the MLS and I'm trying to find the best possible deal for you guys. Put down 25%. That's the perfect way to buy this. That's why real estate investing is the greatest industry in the world. Welcome to the show. Today, we're working for my man, Pablo. Pablo, you are from Buenos Aires, Argentina, bro. That's pretty far from Cleveland, right? Because what we do, we help people like you from all over the world. Don't matter to us where you reside. We will help you invest in the real estate markets that make the most sense, right? We're going to help you pick up properties with only 10 grand out of your pocket, right? But a lot of people, they tell you that, right? A lot of people talk to you guys about picking up properties for 10 grand out of your pocket. I am not the only person in the world, right, that could help you guys find properties where you only need to put down 10 grand, right? There's properties in many places in the United States of America where you only need $10,000 to buy them, right? But I think what people fail to ask when they ask that question is like, where can I get started in real estate for 10K? They fail to ask the question of like, what's that going to look like, right? Like, what's like my experience going to be when I own these properties that only cost 10K, right? And that's why investors from all over the world, they come here to HoltonWise TV, because I break that down for you, man. I'm going to break it down for you in the most realistic way possible. And I better be realistic about it because it's my butt on the line. My team is the team that's going to help you buy the property. My team is the team that's going to manage the property. My team is the team that's going to meet and greet your tenants. We're going to put your tenants in the property. We're going to repaint the property after your tenants move in and out, right? So if it's not doable or if I project to you an ownership experience that's different than the reality, why would you ever come back? You wouldn't, right? You'd be able to Google HoltonWise reviews and see a bunch of investors saying, I say one thing and we do another. You ain't going to see that, right? Go ahead, Google HoltonWise reviews. We got hundreds of reviews on Google, right? A lot of them are 5 stars from investors just like you. And you know what? There's also a lot of 1-star reviews on there. But if you actually read through those reviews, they ain't ever from investors. They're from tenants who don't pay rent. Because you know what? That's part of the game. Sometimes when you're investing in low-income properties, guys, people don't pay rent. And you know what my job is? My job is to kick those motherfuckers out of your house. Because my job is to keep those motherfuckers from stealing from you. And if you read the reviews, I take my job very fucking seriously. So, without further ado, Pablo, brother, let's talk about a property that I know you're going to love because I sent you 2 properties almost identical to it. We've put in offers on those. We're waiting on the sellers, right? There's going to be a lot of high competition for properties like this because they make some serious coin. So let's get into it.
Hey, Steve. What are you doing?
Oh, nothing. Just saving money on my rental property insurance.
Oh, my, Steve. Take me now.
HoltonWise, real estate investing made easy.
Wow, I'm so glad I clicked that link below.
Welcome back. Let's get into the meat, right? We got to see how the sausage is made, right? If you're going to pick up real estate, low-cost real estate, you have to understand the pros and the cons, the good and the bad. You have to understand what you're getting yourself into. 2119 Washington Ave, Lorain, Ohio, 44052. Priced at $50,500, but I do not want you to pay $50,500. I want you to pay $40,000. $40,000 is what I believe I can secure this deal for you, all right? It's been on the market for 7 days, okay? And I believe it's been on the market for 7 days at a very low price because they have a couple issues with the listing and with selling the property, right? Now, I'm not saying those issues are the property itself or even the fault of the seller. It's just the situation that they're in. You see, when you have a house, folks, there's 2 kinds of people that can buy houses, okay? The 2 kinds of people that can buy houses are either going to be people that want to live in those houses, right? People with their family. They need a place to live. That's what a fucking house is, right? It's a place to live, right? That's 1 kind of person. The second is you. Investors. Investors looking for cash flow, right? So if you take half the buyers that could possibly buy your product, being those people that want to live in the house, and you get rid of them, that's going to beat your price down, right? The reason those people can't buy this house is because there's already a tenant in there, right? Thus making it more appealing to you guys, right? The rental property investors, the people that work with me, the people that buy shows on the HoltonWise MLS search and analysis show, right? The people watching HoltonWise TV are the people that want tenants, right? Because y'all ain't going to live in there. You're looking for a cash flow investment, right? But it's not super appealing to you guys either, right? Two reasons for that. Number one, you can't do as much due diligence and research up front as you would typically like to do. This is the only photograph we have been provided for by the listing agent. And it does not paint the home in the greatest scenario, right? This fucking grass doesn't look like it's been cut in two motherfucking weeks. We got fucking blankets on the fucking windows. We got a little bit of peeling paint. I mean, the thing just, nothing screams like, oh, this is awesome, right? Nothing screams that. And then there's no other pictures, no other pictures to allow you to continue to go in and do your due diligence. The reason there's no pictures, because tenants don't like motherfuckers coming in their houses, guys, right? It's just how it is, right? That's the business, okay? They don't want a bunch of people bothering them, right? They've always been like that. When you're working in C, D grade neighborhoods, that's the name of the game. That's what you're jumping into. That's the business you're getting in. If that's a problem for you, if you think that your tenants should be like, oh, there's the landlord. He's so fucking cool. Hey, come on in. My wife made cookies for you, bro. If you're anticipating that to be how the business is, motherfucker, you in the wrong motherfucking business, bro. Pack up shop. Close your fucking iPhone. Go invest in Bitcoin, dude, because real estate investing, it's going to kick you in the fucking dick, all right? That's not for you, dog. On top of that, since it's always been like that, we ran into COVID, right? COVID, Jesus Christ, the people that don't want motherfuckers coming in their houses before, those motherfuckers really don't want you guys in there now, right? So listing agents, a lot of the listing agents that do deals, right? Most real estate agents, folks, they work with people, the other kind of buyer, the kind of people that want to buy houses to live in them, right? Maybe the current owner of this property acquired the property randomly, thought he's going to be a landlord, didn't like it. Now he wants to sell it. So what does he do? He hires the realtor that sold him and his family their, you know, fancy little house with the white picket fence, right? That's how it works a lot of times. A lot of realtors, they don't understand the rental business. The seller probably doesn't understand the rental business. And, you know, it's just not marketed properly, and the tenants are fighting you every step of the way. All that means for everyone is that's how we get properties like this on the market for $50,500 that are going to show $1,000 a month market rent. And that's how they're still on the market a week later, and how I believe I can get you $10,000 off. Because I know how to work through all these issues, right? That's all I do, dude. I don't sell people houses for them to live in, right? If you're like a family in the Cleveland market, and you're like, hey, man, we want to buy a $500,000 house in the suburbs with a cul-de-sac. Like, you want to drive around and look at houses on Sunday? Fuck no, motherfucker! You know how many open houses I've done in my life? Like, fucking one. And it was fucking horrible. And, like, I was like, dude, fuck this, right? Like, there's this other realtor chick there. It was her open house. I was the broker. At one point, we were doing a little bit of residential work, and we had agents working for us, and like, she's fucking baking cookies, and motherfuckers are talking to me about fucking kids soccer teams and fucking design and paint colors. Jesus Christ, it's not my game, man. It's not what I do. 99.5% of the realtors in this market, that's their game. Let them do that. But what we do, folks, what we do is we turn things like this into money. That is my game. That's what I love to do, right? So here are my thoughts. Market rent, 1,000, right? 12K a year, Section 8 tenant, all day, baby. That's what we do at Holton Wise. Now, you don't get to keep that 1,000, people, right? You don't get to keep that, okay? Every month, the average cost estimate between your fixed and variable expense estimates is going to be almost half. It's going to be $459.40. That's not $459.40 every month, right? That's calculating in the long-term performance, right? Leaving you with an NOI of $540.60 a month, or just shy of $6,500 for the year. You buy it at the price I want you to buy it at, $40K. You put up $10, bank puts up $30. That projects out to a 50% cash-on-cash return or a 16.2 cap. But, hold on. Hold the phone before you get too excited. The reason I told you that this wasn't going to appeal to you guys is more than just the fact that there's no pictures, okay? Even if there's no pictures, if something's kicking off a 50% return, right? There's still going to be a high demand for it, right? We ain't there yet, right? One issue we have is the current tenant that's in there, right? The tenant that don't want none of y'all motherfuckers bothering them. They're paying $650 a month plus utilities, so they're paying $725, right? Now, they're paying their $650, plus they're paying gas, electric, water. We have you guys as landlords pay the water just based on how the laws work out here in the water departments. I don't feel like burning a lot of time in this video on why that is. It blows people's minds. So instead, I've created a fact on HoltonWise.com. Check that out. I explain all of that, right? Because if you saw in the chart, I had a line item for you paying the water sewer. It's a whole long story, but you got to pay the water and sewer. That's just how it's going to be, right? So basically right now, current seller, mom and pop landlord, probably not a professional in the business. They're getting $725. Doesn't look as appealing as that $1,000, right? I know through having sold $200 million of investments just like this that this is really a $1,000 rental. But we don't get to just go from $725 to $1,000 like that. It's not how it works, right? We don't want to just take over the property and be like, hey, Mr. Tenant, your rent's now $1,000. Thank you very much, right? They're probably going to move out if you do that. You don't want them to move out because I can almost guarantee you that there is no scenario where this doesn't need a full turnover on the inside. When somebody's been living there a long time, below market rent, and then they move out, you don't just get to broom. You don't get to broom sweep the living room, throw some Febreze in the bathroom, and then move new tenants in at $1,000. That's why it's not a big deal to me that we don't have the photos right now, because I know, just looking at this, just looking at the outside, looking at the grass should tell you this is not going to be brand fucking new when you move in. When these people move out, you're going to have to repaint the walls, probably repaint the counter, the cabinets in the kitchen, probably put in new fixtures in the bathroom, probably replace any carpet that's in there, right? Probably a $10,000, $15,000 turn to get it mint, to get it ready for Section 8, right? I know that that's what you're going to get, right? There's almost no scenario where you won't. Now, we're going to do more due diligence before you actually buy it, right? We're going to have you do a third-party home inspection. Take a look at the big-ticket items, the roof, the furnace, the hot water tank, things of that nature, the big-ticket items. I could tell you right now, none of them are going to be new, man. If you're anticipating buying a property for $40,000 and then the report comes back and the furnace isn't brand new and you're like, oh, hey, James, the furnace ain't new. Can we get $3,000 off? No, motherfucker! Why do you think it was fucking $40,000? It's not like, oh, $40,000 house, but the furnace isn't brand new. It must be a $37,000 house. No! Use your brains. You're going to be getting an old furnace. You're going to be getting an old hot water tank. You're going to be getting an older roof, right? You're probably going to have between 5 and 10 years left of life on all of those items, right? Roofs, they last 30 years. That's a $7,000 roof. Furnaces, 30 years. Furnaces are $3,000. Hot water tanks last 15 years. They're $1,000. You're getting, you know, a living, breathing, kind of worn down rental property, right? That's going to make some money. But no, you ain't getting something that's like perfect, okay? We're going to do the due diligence, get the inspection report so we know exactly what we're getting. If there's something out of the ordinary that makes this not worth $40,000 like other homes in the neighborhood, right, I will let you know. But otherwise, don't anticipate anything being brand new. If you want it to be like super brand new and stuff, like, you know, throw in another like $40,000 on top of this and we'll get you something, right? But if you're trying to be in this price point, set your expectations properly, right? You're going to be getting, you know, kind of an older property, and you're going to be getting a below-market tenant, and that's why we don't want to jack their rent up, right? We want that tenant to stay in there as long as we can keep them in there, increase their rent slowly so we can get them as close to that $1,000 a month as possible without creating an artificial turnover, which creates artificial renovations. In the rental business, folks, people are going to move out of your properties. They don't live there forever. I wish they did. But they don't. That's just the name of the game. So if you're a smart landlord, you don't do more renovations than you need to do. You're going to have the opportunity to do a turnover when this person naturally moves out. At that point, we're going to make it look legit, and we're going to slap a Section 8 tenant in there, and you're going to be at $1,000. Until then, Let's keep collecting that money as it comes in and try to slowly increase the amount of money as it comes in, right? That's the smartest way to do it. And I'm not doing that to be like, Mr. Bleeding Heart over here, let's not put this tenant out. I'm not thinking like that. I'm thinking about you. I'm thinking about your bottom line. It just doesn't make sense for you to say, no, I don't want that money. Let me throw another 15K at it right now. No, that does not make sense. Collect the money as it comes in, and then when the turnover naturally occurs, then you do the investment.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to HoltonWise TV for more financial information, education, and entertainment.